am Navdeep Kaur. I am studying in Leeds Beckett University. Today I will be discussing my own behavior as a consumer as well as marketing. I will start with marketing, which can be described as promoting a certain product to attract a customer in a very could be done by selling it cheaper than the competition or offering better customer service. Second concept is to explain customer behavior. It can be explained through the purchasing habit of the customer. How frequent do they have to do buy a product? Then comes the decision making process. It starts with the problem at a hand and then searching appropriate data, which in turn help the customer to make an informed decision about the product. There are two types of decision making process. There is internal and then external. First one is internal, can be defined once more personality. It could also depend on how the product is performed, and there could be some kind of motivation behind the decision making. Then there are external, such as what social class does one belong to, the financial standing allow them buy the product, and it can be big difference. And what kind of culture has the customer being brought up in does affect the decision making a lot. And next stage is routine. This is decision making on daily basis. It normally involves bare necessities such as food, milk, bread. There are not much thought put into this because products are not expensive and no long commitment is needed. So first purchase I would like to talk about is Dove cream. It is a cheap and easy get it at any local store. I do not have to put much thought into buying it as it is basic need. There is a limited problem solving and there is some effort and thinking put into this problem compared to the routine, and there is a short time commitment needed. The product is caution is also a bit expensive. It could be a clothes, shoe, phone or laptop, etc. The example would be the Ray-Ban glasses I bought for £130. I had to look at different brands in order to find one which suit on my style. The third one is extended decision making. It is applied when buying something expensive while thinking about the long-term benefit of the purchase. This could be anything. From buying a study course or buying car and house. The real life example would be when I had to buy a car and had to look at various factors such as what kind of fuel it used, does it save me any time compared to the public transport, and is it costly to maintain or how long it can be best, taking all these variables. And I decided to buy a Toyota. It is quite inexpensive to maintain and run, and it does save time as compared to the public transport on long journey. Consumer decision making process can be defined through 5 stages. First one is need recognition. The first step to consumer decision making start with knowledge that there is a need for a product. It occurs when customers see that they will be better off in the future and then they are now after buying a product. Third one is evaluation of alternative is the next stage in decision making. After information research, customer involve all the different brand to get for the product. And fourth one is product choice. After research, all the alternative customer will make a decision or on what to buy and where to buy it. Last one is outcome is the post purchase assessment of the product and whether it is to the customer satisfaction or not.